Dear students, today we'll see what do we mean by eye pattern in digital communication system. Now, it is a method, it is a practical way to study the effect of ISI. So, ISI and its effects can be studied by using eye pattern. Now, what exactly this eye pattern is, we'll see. So, let's have our today's topic as eye pattern. Now, if you remember, the basic baseband binary data transmission, what we had seen earlier. With that block diagram, we will know exactly where the problem of recovering of data in the receiver comes into picture. So here in the first block, we are showing a pulse generator. Okay, so the input is a binary data. Say if the input is 1010, then a proper clock pulses are given to them so that a proper pulse waveform is formed here. Okay, so let it be a polar waveform or a unipolar waveform, a proper waveform which can represent 1010 will be formed, and then it is properly filtered and given to the channel. Okay, and then in the channel it might get influenced by a white Gaussian noise, and there might be regenerative repeaters in the a channel, and the received wave comes to the receiver part, and in the receiver part is the first is the receiving filter, and then you get the distorted wave. The wave which is called as YT will be distorted version of the input binary pulse waveform. Okay, and then that at every time interval, pulse time interval, we are going to take it for the decision device. If the amplitude, incoming amplitude, is more than a reference voltage called as threshold, then the output will be binary 1. If the YT is less than the threshold voltage, reference voltage, then the output is binary 0. In that way, we are going to detect the binary 1s and 0s. Okay. Now here, the waveform which we sent was say 1010. Okay. At the transmitter level, it was showing like this 1010. Okay, so at the transmitter level, this is the waveform what we are going to send. Now, after it travels through the channel, okay, and noise getting interfered with it, it gets distorted, and in that distortion, it can overlap on the neighboring or the adjacent bits. So here you can see you might get a output like this. First one might look like this, zero might look like this, again one might look like this, again zero might look like this. Okay, so a distorted output of 1010 you will get at the receiver stage. Okay, now this distorted output, if you put on a single time interval, then you will get something as eye pattern, and which will give you to study what is ISI, that is inter-symbol interference, and its effects. Okay, so inter-symbol interference was the phenomena what we studied, in which, okay, in a communication system, when the data is being transmitted in the form of pulses, the output produced at the receiver due to other bits or symbols interferes with the output produced by the desired bit. So the particular bit what you are going to decode, in that process, there will be influence of the adjacent bits. Okay, and this effect will be called as inter-symbol interference, ISI, and this is an error which is detected in the receiver. Okay, now to study this ISI, we should get use of a method called as eye pattern, and here comes the topic of eye pattern. Okay, so here, what is an eye pattern initially? Digital data is transmitted as sampled values in sequential or serial data transmission. When the output sample placed one after another, then overlapping happens due to various facts like ISI, inter-symbol interference. The overlap pattern form a shape of human eye. That is why it is called as eye pattern or diagram. Okay, so it is an eye pattern which is displayed on the CRO. The shape of this pattern resembles with the shape of human eye. That is why it is called as eye pattern. Eye pattern is a practical way to study the ISI, that is intersymbol interference effect. The eye pattern provides a great deal of information about the performance of the system because it will study the received waveform. Eye patterns can be observed using an oscilloscope, that is CRO. The received wave is applied to the vertical deflection plates of an oscilloscope and the sawtooth wave at a rate equal to the transmitted symbol rate. Say it is, if the hot time period of every sample is TB, then 1 upon TB will be the symbol rate of the sawtooth waveform which you are going to apply to the horizontal plates of the oscillator. Okay, then a resulting display will give you a eye pattern which resembles to human eye. Then we will take an example here. Now this example will make things clear for you. So here initially we have shown binary data. So here you can see binary data. Now this binary data we have taken as 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0. Okay. Now that binary data in electrical waveform at the transmitter stage will be transmitted like this. This will be your 1, this will be 0, this will be 1, 1, 0, 1, 0. Okay. Now every bit will have a time period which is called as TB. TB. Therefore, the sampling time period, okay, is TB and the sampling frequency will be 1 upon TB. Okay, now when you receive this distorted waveform of this pattern, now this 10111010, this was something which was transmitted at the receiver. When you receive the distorted waveform, then your logic 1 will be looking like this, logic 0 will be looking like this, here 1, 1, this 0 will be looking like this, 1 and this 0. As an example, we have taken this and they will be with reference to the time period only, time period what we had said earlier. Now this received waveform, you apply to the Y deflection plates of a CRO, Y deflection plates, okay, that is vertical or deflection plates of CRO. And at horizontal or deflection plates of CRO, you apply a sawtooth waveform at the rate of 1 by TB. 1 by TB, the same time period what you have taken for the pulse. Okay, then what will happen is, at a single interval, say you are having one interval like this TB. This is a single interval. Okay, so this is a single interval TB. Now in this interval, you are going to put each of the received waveform. Say first we will take this one. So one will be drawn like this. Then we will take this zero in this time period. This zero will be drawn like this. Then we will take this one. This one will be drawn like this. Then we will take this one. This one will be drawn here like this. Then we will take this zero, received one. Then this zero will take like this. Then we will take this one. This one will be drawn like this. And then we will take this zero. This zero will be drawn like this. Okay. Now, every received waveform at the time period of TB is put on a single interval. And on a single interval, if you see here, it looks like a human eye. It looks like a human eye. Now this human eye opening we have shown here and this time period we have shown, this is the human eye opening, that is this section, this is what you see is a human eye opening, and this will give you a study how the intersymbol interference is occurring and what are the errors in the sampling time, what are the errors in the noise margin, what are the errors in the amplitude. All that thing can be studied with this eye pattern. Now this will resemble to human eye, so we can call it as an eye pattern. Now what are the things we can study in this eye pattern? So if you see here a simplified eye pattern, you can see when you open this eye, this period from here, you can see this period from here till here is called the time interval over which the signal can be sampled. That is the time interval over which the signal can be sampled, that is TB, whatever you can get. And the center of that will be your best sampling time. That is, this will be your best sampling time. Best sampling time will be the center of it. And then the slope of it, this slope, whatever you get of the waves, of the received waveform, that slope gives sensitivity to timing errors, okay? And then whatever amplitudes you have of the received waveform, okay? So this part, whatever you have here and whatever you have here, this part, this will be distortions at sampling times, okay? This will be the margin of your noise margin, okay? And this will again be on the timeline, this, if you see, it will be distortion at the zero crossing. At the zero crossing, say if this is your sampling time, and if you are crossing something like this, then you are not crossing at the zero. At this point, you are crossing ahead or before. Okay, so that will be a given. And then you have this maximum signal voltage V2, and then a threshold voltage here. But the main things are the slope of the waveform, the time interval where the eye is open, the noise margin where the eye is widest open, and then the distortion of the zero signal crossing. Okay, these are the things what you can graphically study on the CRO by observing the eye pattern of the received waveform of baseband binary data or transmitted wave, okay, where the eye is open widest. So here you can see it is the widest opening, the best sampling time is this, okay? So the sensitivity of the system to the timing error is determined by the rate of closure of the eye. So this sensitivity is determined by the rate of closure of the eye, okay? As the sampling rate is varied, the height of the eye opening, that is the height of the eye opening, that is this part, at a specified sampling time defines the margin over noise. So how much you are going to open, how much the eye is going to open, will give you margin over noise. So here you can have this height opening, okay? So this height opening, and here you can see this margin, okay? So this is noise margin, and above that, if it goes, you can take it as noise margin, okay? And that can be given by the height of the eye opening, okay? So these points can be concluded as what we are going to study, or what the eye pattern is going to interpret, as follows. An eye pattern provides the following information about a particular system. Number one, actual eye patterns are used to estimate the bit error rate and the signal to noise ratio. Number two, the width of the eye opening defines the time interval. As I've told you earlier, the width of the eye opening defines the time interval over which the received wave can be sampled without error from ISI. The instant of time when the eye opening is wide will be preferred time for sampling. Number four will be the rate of closure of the eye according to the sampling time determines how sensitive the system is to the timing error. And number five, the height of the eye opening at a specified sampling time defines the margin over noise. Hence, the interpretation of the eye pattern is an important consideration. So when the effect of ISI is severe, the eye is completely closed and it is impossible to avoid errors due to the combined presence of ISI and noise in the system. So to study those effects, this is one method. The eye pattern is one method where you can study the margin over noise, the slope sensitivity of the timing error, and the distortion at the zero crossing, and the time interval over which the wave can be sampled. So all these things can be studied with the help of eye pattern. Okay. Thank you, students.